वेलकम बैक टू आवर सेकेंड यूनिट स्पोर्ट्स एंड न्यूट्रिशन। वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड टू पार्ट्स इन द सेकेंड यूनिट। द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट बैलेंस डाइट एंड न्यूट्रिशन। वी हैड इलैबोरेटेड मैक्रो एंड माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स। फर्दर वी हैव स्टडीड इन द सेकेंड पार्ट द न्यूट्रिटिव एंड नॉन न्यूट्रिटिव कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द डाइट। एंड नाउ इन द थर्ड पार्ट we are going to study in detail about the eating for weight control, in which we are further going to study in detail about a healthy weight, the pitfalls of dieting, food intolerance and food myths. Meaning of healthy weight. According to the National Institute of Health, a healthy weight is considered to be as the one that is between 19 and 25 BMI. So BMI here refers to as body mass index. If the BMI is between 25 and 29 in an adult, it is considered to be as overweight. Whereas if the BMI is 30 or greater, the person is considered to be as obese. Usually an individual who has a healthy weight leads to a healthy life with a reduced risk of diseases. It means that if an individual has a healthy weight, he can lead to a healthy life. On the other hand, if an individual has unhealthy weight or overweight, he or she is not able to lead a healthy life. It can also be said that a healthy weight is the weight which lowers an individual's risk for various health problems such as heart diseases, strokes, high blood pressure, and diabetes. Completed with the meaning of healthy weight. Now we are going to study about the two popular methods to find out or calculate the healthy weight, that is the height and weight chart and body mass index. Height and weight chart tells us about healthy body weight, whereas another method is based on BMI, using which one can come to know whether one has a healthy body weight or not. So this is the chart that shows the method to know healthy weight through height and weight, which is further divided into male and female chart. The next popular method to calculate healthy weight is BMI method, which is also known as body mass index. If you want to know your body mass index, there is a simple formula to know it. That is, divide your body weight in kgs by your height in meters square. Healthy BMI for both women's and men's are same. According to the World Health Organization, there are different categories with the basis of BMI, which are divided. The categories are divided into underweight, normal weight, overweight, obesity. The obesity is divided into three classes: obesity class 1, obesity class 2, and obesity class 3. Now, we will differentiate between the categories and BMI. So, underweight category consists of BMI less than 18.5, whereas 18.5 to 24.9 BMI is considered to be in normal weight, whereas 25 to 29.9 is considered in the overweight. Whereas obesity class 1, the BMI should be between 30 to 34.9, obesity class 2, 35 to 39.9, and the obesity class 3 is greater than 40. The shown is a tabular format of category and BMI, which will make you easy to understand. We have studied about healthy weight and also have studied about different methods to calculate healthy weight. As we are knowing which category we are in, so now it's the time to study about the methods how to control healthy body weight. The methods to control healthy body weight constitute of 13 methods. The first one is set an appropriate goal. The second one is lay stress on health, not on weight. Third one is cut your calories. Fourth, active lifestyle. Fifth, bring out support.
Sixth, yogic exercises. Seventh, avoid fatty foods. Eighth one is avoid junk and fast food. Ninth, avoid overeating. 10th, don't eat smaller meal frequently. Avoid rich carbohydrate food. Don't skip your meals. 13th, regular exercise or physical activities. 14th, balancing the intake of calories and expenditure of calories. Now we'll elaborate the first point, that is set an appropriate goal. So for losing body weight, you should set an appropriate goal. That is how much weight you want to shed or lose. While setting the goal, you should know your capabilities and your limitations. As your physical education teacher tells you that your goal should be achievable. So this is also a point that is considered. Take a place that you will lose 1 kg per month depending on how much excess weight you have. After that, you can further set your goals for weight control. Second point is lay stress on health, not on weight. It is a well-known fact that losing weight for health rather than appearance can make it easier to set reasonable goals. From the point of view of health, you can make efforts to achieve or maintain a body mass index between the range of 18.5 and 24.9. If your BMI or waist measures beyond this limit, you may be at risk or contracting various diseases. So, from the point of view of your health, try to maintain these limits. Third one, cut your calories. Keep a plan ready to get back on the track. If your body weight begins to exceed the required level, it is a simple plan to follow. Just cut or subtract only 100 calories a day. In this way, you can return to your set goals. Fourth, active lifestyle. An active dynamic lifestyle plays a particular role in controlling weight. School children should prefer to walk to the school instead of going by car or motorbike. Instead of elevators, they should take staircase. If they want to switch off the TV, they should not use remote control but should do this physically. They should not watch TVs for more than an hour. Instead of watching TV for more than an hour, they should play outside. In this way, they can lead an active lifestyle, which will be beneficial in the weight control. The next is bring out support. No doubt you can lose or maintain your weight without anybody's support, but if you get support from other people, it makes the process of losing weight easier or more pleasant. Tell the people who are close or your friends that your intention, that you are serious about and are committed of losing weight. Missing to meet a partner for the regular schedule, gym time is a great way to stick to a workout routine. Such type of support can be sought for the lifetime. It will help you in maintaining your weight. Next is yogic exercises. Yogic exercises can help in controlling as well as maintaining proper weight. For example, pranayam and yogic asanas are helpful in controlling weight. As a matter of fact, researchers studies have proved that stress and tension tends to increase weight. Meditative asanas are beneficial in relieving stress and tension. Therefore, yogic exercises can also be used for keeping a good control on weight. The seventh one is to avoid fatty foods. If you want to lose or maintain weight, you should avoid fatty food in your diet. Fats are known to have a maximum number of calories. As you all know that we need extra cheese on the food that we eat. The extra calories will be accumulated in your body, so avoid fatty food if you want to remain healthy. Eighth one, avoid junk and fast food. Try to avoid junk and fast foods such as pizza, burger, chips, cookies, pastries, chocolate, cold drink and so on. If you want to lose weight, these foodstuffs are also rich in empty calories. intake of such foodstuffs lead to the condition of overweighting. Avoid overeating. To control or maintain weight, you should not overeat. It means that you should eat food as per the requirement of your body. Suppose you require 2000 calories per day, then you should take the food that consists of 2000 calories. If you take 2100 calories per day, the 100 calories will be accumulated daily as fat in your body. So you should avoid overeating. Don't eat smaller meals frequently. You should not form a habit of eating smaller meals frequently. So, avoid eating smaller meals to avoid adding excess fat to our body. It is 11th. Avoid rich carbohydrate food. To lose weight, avoid rich carbohydrate foods. But it does not mean that you should not take carbohydrates at all. Carbohydrate is necessary to increase the level of energy. So you should just reduce the amount of carbohydrate in your diet, not completely eradicate carbohydrate food. For this purpose, try to avoid sugar, rice, potatoes, toffees, chocolates, and other sweets. The next is 12th. Don't skip meals. Don't skip your meals such as breakfast, lunch, and dinner. If you skip your meal, the next time you will definitely indulge in overeating, which may lead to obesity. In fact, skipping your meal increases hunger and it results in greater food consumption in the next meal that you take. The 13th one is regular exercise or physical activities. Exercise helps to control your weight by using excess calories. On the other hand, if you do not exercise, the excess calories will be stored as a fat. In fact, your body weight is regulated by the number of calories you take in and use each day. In reality, whatever you eat contains calories and whatever you do uses calories. Even calories are used while breathing, sleeping, and digesting food. Regular exercise or physical activities is a vital part of weight loss. Research studies consistently indicate that regular physical activities such as aerobic exercises and strengthening exercises for at least 30 minutes combined with healthy eating habits is the healthiest way to control weight for lifetime. 14th one is balancing the intake of calories and expenditure of calories. For maintaining a healthy weight, you should always try to strike a balance between your intake of calories and expenditure of calories. For implementing this, try not to eat more calories than your body burns each day. Always stick to your eating plan even on a holidays or functions. If your intake of calories is more than what you need, the excess calories are stored as fat. Too much stored fats raised your BMI and makes it hard to return to your aimed weight. It is usually said that you may lose your body weight for a shorter period, but it is difficult to maintain it for a lifetime. Indeed, it requires a strong willpower, dedication, firm determination, persistent endeavors, and motivational to control weight and maintain a healthy weight. The next sub-point is the pitfalls of dieting. Nowadays, everyone wants to remain slim and trim, especially on the girls. People who are overweight use various methods to lose weight. Most of them adhere to dieting. In the beginning, dieting produces good result or success, but after the initial success, it adds more weight later on. Even research studies indicate that 90% of dieters gain all their weight back and sometimes more than that. In fact, we are all aware that shedding or losing weight is not as simple as it sounds. Eat less and exercise more to burn calories. We know the scientific facts, but it is difficult to implement them. In fact, there are some pitfalls of dieting that keep us away from losing or reducing weight. The major pitfalls can be elaborated as follows. There are total 7 pitfalls of dieting. The first one is extreme reduction of calories. For dieting, intake of calories is reduced extremely. If you reduce intake of calories, it will result in a huge loss of weight. It can be dangerous for you. It will definitely lower your metabolism, and as a result of this, your body weight will not be reduced in a healthy manner. The second pitfall is restriction of some nutrients. Generally, some nutrients like carbohydrates and fats are restricted in dieting. In reality, your body needs all type of nutrients. If you don't take all the nutrients in the required amount, the proper functioning of the body will be hampered. The next is skipping meals. It is a fact that if you have good metabolic rate, you can maintain or lose weight. So, skipping meal work against your weight loss plan. Research studies also show if you skip one meal, you take more calories during the next meal. The fourth pitfall is intake of calories through beverages. If you want to lose your weight, most probably you're less stressed on not to eat more and not on what you drink. In fact, beverages, coffee with cream and sugar, sweetened juices and soda really contribute to weight gain. The fifth one is underestimating the calories. In fact, the most of the persons who go on dieting usually underestimate the number of calories they consume. So it is essential to be more aware of the amount of calories you take in your diet. The sixth one is intake of labeled foods. Most of the persons who go on dieting usually go for such food products that carry a label: sugar-free, low calories, or no fats, or fat-free. Such type of food is not always the best for losing weight. In addition to it, that does not meet all the nutrients required to your body. As a fact, 3 chocolate biscuits contain 140 calories, whereas 3 non-fat cookies contain 120 calories. This difference is insignificant. Apart from this, we eat such products, you think that these products have a very few calories, and so you tend to eat more, as a result of which you end up conserving more calories. The last pitfall is non-exercising. If you go on dieting and do not exercise, it will work against the weight loss program. Instead of losing weight, you are likely to gain weight. As a matter of fact, exercise has a positive effect on metabolism and also helps to burn some extra calories. Exercise increases metabolic rate, which ultimately reduces body weight. So dieting is beneficial only if you do exercise. The next point is food intolerance. Food intolerance is more common than food allergy. Food intolerance is a term used widely for varied physiological responses associated with particular food. Some persons can tolerate a reasonable amount of the food, but if they eat too much or too often, they give symptoms of food intolerance because their body cannot tolerate unlimited amounts. Food intolerance comes on gradually, not frequently. It is not life-threatening. Now we'll study about the causes of food intolerance. Food intolerance is caused by a part of complete absence of activity of the enzyme responsible for breaking down or absorbing the food elements. These deficiencies are usually innate. Sometimes food intolerance can be diet-related or can be due to illness. The symptoms of food intolerance. Food intolerance can cause nausea, stomach pain, diarrhea, vomiting, gas, cramps, heartburns, headaches, irritability, and nervousness. Management of food intolerance. Individuals can try minor changes of diet to exclude food causing adverse reactions. Sometimes it can be managed adequately in such a way without the need for professional assistance. If you are unable to know the food which causes problems, you should seek expert or medical help. Guidance can also be provided by a general practitioner to assist in diagnosis and management. For managing food intolerance, fructose intolerance therapy, lactose intolerance therapy, and histamine intolerance therapy can be applied. This was all about the management of food intolerance. The last point of unit 2 is food myths. There are various food myths which are prevailing not only in India but also all over the world. What to eat, when to eat, and how often to eat are such questions which usually confuse most of the individuals. We believe in such myths because they sound like they could be true. Nowadays, we have scientific knowledge, and on the basis of that knowledge, we should not believe in food myths. There are various food myths that we are going to study, in which the first one is potatoes makes you fat. Earlier, people used to think the carbohydrate-rich food such as rice, potato, etc. increase your body weight. So, for losing or reducing weight, they used to eliminate carbohydrate-rich food from the diet. Now we know that carbohydrates are the body preferred energy sources. Potatoes do not automatically make you fat. So, there is no problem in intaking potatoes in moderate quantity. The next myth is fat-free products will help you losing weight. Fat-free labeled products can lead you weight gain. In fact, these foods have more calories. Approximately, these products have the same number of calories or may change slightly in comparison to other regular foods. In addition to that, most of the persons eat more quantity of labeled food under the misconception that it comprises of less calories. However, they ultimately consume more calories, which can cause weight gain. The third myth is egg increases cholesterol, so avoid them. Eggs are undoubtedly good source of health. The egg provides various nutrients such as protein, vitamin A, B, D, zinc, iron, calcium, phosphorus, etc. It also fulfills the daily requirement of cholesterol by our body. So taking one egg daily causes no problem in the level of cholesterol. Moving to the fourth myth, drinking while eating makes you fat. The actual fact behind the misconception is that enzymes and their digestive juices will be diluted by drinking water while eating. It will slow down your digestion, which may lead to excess body fat. There is a scientific fact that drinking water while eating improves digestion. Moving forward to the fifth myth, don't take milk immediately after eating fish. Many people believe that you should not take milk immediately after eating fish. They think that it will make you sick. Some people even think that spots can be appeared on your skin if you consume milk after eating fish. As a matter of fact, there is no scientific reason in taking milk immediately after eating fish. Indeed, these products may be taken together. Sixth myth is starve yourself if you want to lose weight. Eating a good diet is more important than not to eat when you are on weight loss program. Include such food items in your diet which suppress appetite and increase metabolism so that you don't eat too much. So there is no need to starve yourself if you want to lose weight. So the last myth is exercise makes you eat more. It's a total misconception. Exercise burns calories, which may increase your hunger. Research studies conducted in this area have not shown that the individuals who do exercise consume more calories than those who don't exercise. So there is no truth in this statement. This was all about Unit 2. I hope you have understood this unit. In the next lecture, we are going to study about the third unit, that is yoga and lifestyle. So be ready and be safe. Take care.